They came from both sides with a double spear. And it's funny because they had full intention of jumping this nigga. Old nigga was the rat this whole time. He really pulled up just to confirm his kill. When they revealed who the monarch was, it was this nigga Omni-Man. And what made it worse is that this nigga hit that, had a whole nother child. You know it's bad when they got you walking barefoot. But when he looked at the knife, the tip was bent. So now she's staying with her parents, and I have the feeling she gonna be on her Tobey Maguire shit, throwing away the suit for a little while. Nolan dropped down and was like, "Bro, what are you doing? Lock the fuck in." But all it took was the words, "Lock the fuck in," and bro started moving like a seasonal boxer. Somehow this nigga Steve is still alive and came through with a backbreaker. But he pretty much says that Nolan is gonna get executed, and now Mark has to conquer Earth in his place. Yo, I'm not gonna lie to y'all. Making us wait 3 months for the second part is kinda crazy. Like, I rock with Invincible Heavy, but come on, bro. Y'all is not Attack on Titan. That is the only show that's allowed to do that. But y'all already know I be tuned in, and low-key, episode 5 was kinda cool. But since this is the first episode back, I'ma pass it off to my boy, Akite.
We start off with my guy, Mark, after he and his dad got absolutely jumped and beat. And we see the carnage that the Viltrumites caused. Mark has to give bad news to Nolan's other baby mama, telling her that Pops got snuck and taken away. And she like, "Damn, that's tough. How about you help us rebuild, though? And then we'll get you a ride home." 2 months later, we see that he's rebuilding, ship is ready, and they tell his ass, "All right, bro, go home." And he's like, "Nah, I still gotta help around here. Plus, the Earth will be okay without me." Cut to the Earth, and they got like 20 heroes out here to fight one discount abomination. They even called the baddies out. They might need bro to come back, I'm not gonna lie. Because if the baddies is out here fighting, the Earth is in dire need of better heroes. So Nolan's bug wife is like, "Hey, I'm old as hell. Take your brother with you to Earth. Cause me, I got like 3 more days in me. Maybe 4 if I'm lucky." And at first he's like, "Nah, you're his mom. He needs you." And she's like, "Bro, look at me. Shit, me personally, I still crap."
"You what?"
So Mark gets back home, brings his brother. He sees his mom, lets her know about everything that happened. And she's obviously in shock and sick as fuck that her old nigga went and made another kid. Got kidnapped. And now she has to handle raising his new kid. So she's like, "Nah, I don't want that little nigga." And Mark is like, "Okay, I'll handle him. I'll drop out of college. I'll just be a dad for a year." And mom is like, "Nah, that ain't finna work, gang." And he's like, "Well, we can't give this nigga away. He's purple. Nigga look like Thanos. Don't nobody want no Thanos baby." So mom caves in and says she'll take care of the baby. So we cut to Cecil working, and Donald comes in pressing bro. Tell him to tee the fuck up and slide some answers for what happened when Omni-Man ran his fade last season. And Cecil is like, "Bro, I'ma keep it a buck with you. You want Android, bro. Dr. Gero style. 17-0-18. We got you out here working harder, even after death, because that's just the world we live in. Motherfucker really grabbed his reboot card just to tell him to get back to work. Me personally, I wouldn't let that slide. I'd be sick as fuck." So Mark pulls up to school, gives his homie a little update, and hears that the college is 2 seconds away from kicking his ass out. And he's like, "That's cool, but I gotta go see Bae." Cecil pulls up though and tries to hit Mark with the "Where my hug at?" But Mark is like, "Nah, bro, I got a life outside this hero stuff. And even in that life, I'm saving people. So there ain't no hug today." And Cecil was like, "Bro, the Guardians have been getting washed without you." We see the Guardians fighting 5 and below Abomination, and yeah, they were getting cooked. Sorry ass team. So Cecil was like, "Look, bro, you know what's up with your whole situation, and we finna take Thanos up off your hand." And Mark is like, "Nah, you not taking Lil bro." And Cecil was like, "I don't care what you say. We already got niggas at the house." Mark is like, "You touch Lil bro, I'ma crash out. Now excuse me, I'ma go talk to my bitch, and you gonna step out the way." And Cecil folds, like, immediately. I wasn't expecting that. I was expecting a little more resistance. But again, it's invincible to a regular ass nigga. What you really gonna do? Like, I know he was able to dodge Omni-Man that one time, but this nigga Mark, like, right up in his face. Do he really got the facilities to do anything this close? I don't think so. So Mark updates his girl on what happened. And she's like, "Damn, that's tough. Me, on the other hand, I failed a test that's 1/3 of my grade. My grandpa died. And the second I heard the grandpa died thing, I started stressing. Like, no, she cheated on my nigga." Because you know, anytime a girl's grandma or grandpa died, it's followed up by, "I was sad, I did some stuff because I was hurt, you weren't around and somebody else was." I really thought she was about to say some shit that would have made even me crash out. I thought she was about to hit him with the, "I let the whole softball team hit." I'd be up in there like, "Softball team? All of them hit you? Nah, I'm Omni-Man 2 in this bitch. So then we cut to the Guardians training, and Rudy, a robot, whichever you like, is like, yo, Immortal, Monster Girl's powers make her even more of a minor, so I'm not trying to be any more of a weirdo than I already am, so stop pressing her. And Monster Girl's like, no, nigga, stop coochie watching. If you get this clingy after one date, then consider that your last. And Rex pulls up and's like, oh shit, 8th grade drama serious in this bitch. I ain't know we had a daycare to run. And Cecil pulls up, straight gives that boy a jump scare, and lets them know, hey guys, we have company. Bro thinks this a Marvel movie for real. He shows that a ship from Mars is headed straight to Earth, and whatever is in it most likely wants smoke. And Shapesmith, aka Sonic, is like, okay guys, I have a secret. I'm from Mars. And Cecil's like, nigga, we know? You thought we'd let you on the team without knowing what you are? So he's like, damn, well, I have another secret. When Invincible came to Mars with the other spacemen, I knocked one of them out, traded places with them because I always wanted to travel the stars, and I know what's on that ship. It's most likely the evil space thing took over the nigga I knocked out, and they on their way here. And everyone starts panicking, but Rex is like, hold on guys, I have an idea.
Alright bro, let me get the mic back. Yo, I think Rex is the only one who knows how broken Adam Eve can be. That's why he pulled up on her and gave her a little motivational speech, and now she's back in the field. Now imagine if Adam Eve wasn't nerfed by being a hero. She don't even gotta be a full villain. If she was like an anti-hero, man, she would be a problem. Her power is like manipulating atoms or something like that. I don't know if she has to have some knowledge on what she's turning something into, but if not, she can probably turn the air around you into poison, turn the dirt into nukes if she so wanted. Nah, this universe needs a Batman. They need a contingency plan for her ass. If she go evil, who's stopping her? So Mark finally asks about the books his pops was talking about, and we already know Debbie sold them junks. She was not keeping that shit in her crib. That's when Cecil came through, told Mark about the mission, and took off to space. But these creatures thrive off pure violence. They don't care who you are, it's on sight. And I'll just chop this one off as Rex carried. Without his draft pick, we would have lost half the team. So they pushed their way through the ship and homeboy done goofed, punching that thing to spawn a tsunami. And for most of this fight, I'm like, damn, does nobody have an AoE attack? Punching them one at a time is not gonna work. Then Robot Man actually came through on one and knocked them out, but it lasted about 5 seconds. Adam Eve had to come through with a clutch save again. The game plan was for Robot Man to boost that AoE attack, but Adam Eve ain't have enough juice to hold that barrier. Good thing homeboy is able to buy enough time for Rudy to finish, and when Immortal got it, Mark had no reason to shoulder check that nigga like that. And not only that, he little boyed him too. Nah, this is payback for that one time he pulled up on him just to talk shit. Later on, when Mark was walking home, this nigga Immortal pulls up just to hate. Nigga, your shoes whack, your hair whack, your fit whack, your mama whack, your daddy whack. Matter of fact, nigga, eat a Frank. So he ended up getting close enough to hit him with a shockwave, picked him up, tried to get the hell up on out of there, but the Martians was like, yeah, well, you see, we appreciate y'all for helping, but that nigga gotta die. Totally understandable. They left that scene with efficiency. Now, with all this going on, King Lizard was also planning an attack. So Rex and them pulled up, and there's so much shit going on. Shorty is over here going small just to get backhanded, while K is over here getting bullied. Look at this, spawn some clones, slip, neck grab, sit your dumb ass down. Can't even show that, it was pure evisceration. She spawned some more, and not gonna lie, at first she was putting in that work. These were excellent plays right here. At least until Bro just started throwing her around. He then grabbed her by the neck, and I was like, no way, it's not gonna end like this, right? She tried to get away, but Bro said, the fuck is you going? I be forgetting how brutal this show is. No build up, no nothing, just straight death. And then it cuts to my boy Rex getting jumped. And look how he had to run into position to get that hit in. Nigga wants to be involved so bad. And Ray is over here jumping into people's eyelids. Nigga, losing like that would suck. But getting eaten alive is probably way worse. I thought we was good though. She was just gonna return back to her normal size and murk the nigga. I was wrong. This man was squeezing his muscles so hard that Shorty got crushed in his body. Now, Rex made the logical decision to fucking skedaddle. And Green Girl was actually ass. She lost to a spam attack. Big dude gonna spin back though. Slip, quick two-piece. He was about to throw another bomb, but this nigga wants to eat everything. Rex may have lost a hand, but that boy lost his head. And of course, the boss always has to come last.
Gun to the back of your head, name 5 DDG songs.
Just do it, you prick.
At this moment, I was going through a range of emotions. Sadness. Anger.
Now, I'm really mad.
confusion, cause ain't no way y'all kill my boy like that. But Rex said he going for a triple-double this game. Got up and started swinging, beating that nigga's ass with his nub. But this gotta be some type of world record. First of all, the fact that he was breathing on his nigga neck and still fucked up the shot is insane. Second of all, how do you allow the nigga you just shot in the head get up and beat your ass? Nothing but nub shots. This gotta be the highest tier of ass one person can possibly get to. Then these officers walk in and one of them go, "Sir, are you all right?" Anyways, turns out Ray also survived. But when the others came back from space, it was nothing good. They held a funeral for Kate. Ray is holding up in there, but at least my nigga Rex is gonna be alright. He's getting a new hand and everything. Also, in between all this, Mark and Amber broke up, but we knew it was gonna happen. It was just a matter of time. And it was his whole thing of them talking to someone about how they can go about fixing this, but that shit just ain't gonna work. Mark, you can't have no regular girl, bro. Unless you okay with seeing them once every 12 business days, you need a girl who can be in the field with you. I think it's time to give it up, bro. And after getting jumped by 3 Viltrumites, our boy Alan has made a full recovery. Whole time we thinking O'Hare was an op, but turns out he was a rebel Viltrumite this whole time. Then Alan was given the mission to bring Mark back here. But after the death of Kate, this dude Immortal was losing it. They saw someone pulling up to Earth and he thought it was Omni-Man. But to be honest, nigga, you're lucky it was an Omni-Man, cause in every timeline that man has whooped your ass. Matter of fact, if Alan so wanted, he could have beat your ass too. You're lucky that Mark, for whatever reason, was taking a Sunday stroll through space. So long story short, Mark said he's not going to space again, so instead he showed Alan the books Omni-Man was talking about, which by the way he got from Art. And he believes these books are showing them ways to hurt a Viltrumite. Then it cuts to Omni-Man getting bullied, and I truly don't know how you finna get out, cause even if we find that overpowered ass weapon, we first have to get Omni-Man off the ship to use it. And the only people we know who can hang with Viltrumites is Mark on a good day, Alan, O-Head, and probably his little bro whenever he gets older. I highly doubt 4 niggas is taken out of Viltrumite army. But at the end, it showed us Megamind getting fitted up for the occasion. He finally returned home. Now, we got 2 episodes left, and hopefully season 3 don't take too long, cause nigga, I am invested.